Boa tarde e bem-vindos a esta emissão em direto da Euronews a partir de Bruxelas para a cobertura da 4ª Cimeira da União Europeia-África que decorre entre hoje e amanhã. Os chefes de Estado e de Governo vão estabelecer as prioridades de cooperação para os próximos 3 anos. A agenda será dominada por temas tais como o investimento, a segurança, a pobreza e a migração. Na última década, o Produto Interno Bruto de África cresceu em média quase 5% ao ano, mas o continente continua marcado por conflitos e pobreza que levam milhares de pessoas a procurarem refúgio na Europa. With me in the studio is Sanusi Bilal, analyst from European Centre for Development Policy Management. Thank you very much for accepting our invitation. We will start by speaking about migration, which is a fundamental topic in this summit. There will be, especially after the Lampedusa tragedy when so many hundred people died, there will be a declaration to be signed on how to combat these networks that traffic people. But there are not actually any plans, you know, for safe corridors for legal migration or other political measures. What is your opinion on how to tackle the problem of migration from Africa to Europe?
Well, of course, the very important point is to address the tragedy that especially legal migration is, and the fact that you have so many people that leaving their country because of poor conditions in their own countries and hoping to find a better life. These are not people that are just trying to take advantage of a European system, but these are people who are just trying to make a living and contribute and hope to have a better life. So I think that to avoid the exploitation of that hope and expectations that migrants have in trying to, in being sometimes forced to leave their country or trying to look for a better way of living, is an issue that is of concern, of course, for both parties, for both Africa and Europe. And you cannot combat illegal migration simply at the European border. You have to look at the problems already from the countries where the migration is originating from, and including the countries where they are crossing the border. So I think the fact that there is a cooperation between Europe and Africa on these issues is something to be most welcome.
The fact is that two-thirds of the African population is under 35 years old. They have no jobs, and that's how you said the reason they are coming here. The European aid is going to be channeled more for entrepreneurship, for vocational training. Is this also a chance for the European young people, highly trained, to participate in this knowledge transfer, and the two continents could benefit?
Well, yes. First, I mean, not two-thirds of the young population in Africa doesn't have jobs. In fact,
no, they are under 35, and many of them don't have jobs.
And the level of youth unemployment is lower in Africa than it is in many European countries. Mm-hmm. So, in that respect, I think we have to look at first what is happening in Africa, and in fact, the transformation of Africa will come from Africa itself first, and the jobs creations is a priority for many African countries, and
but that
will
the
come from their own reforms. I think they are not dependent just, or these jobs creations will not just come out of the goodwill of the Europeans. Having said that, the Europeans can help and can try to facilitate and accompany this transformation process that is taking place in Africa. But of course, it's not for Europe to create all the jobs for Africa. This is not the way it is working. This is not the way the Africans are seeing it. But indeed, if one wants to tackle, you started from the issue of migration, the issue is how Europe can best accompany and facilitate the transformation process that many African countries are engaging in, or create additional incentives to do so.
Of course, Africa is growing a lot and is creating a lot of wealth. But the truth is also that half of the population live in extreme poverty. You know, and a lot of these people, 400 million people, live in rural areas. There is so much agricultural potential untapped. What to do in terms of food security, and how can Europeans partner with Africans to solve this issue?
Well, then that's an area, in fact, on food security where there's an extremely good cooperation between Africa and Europe. The Africans are engaged in a comprehensive agricultural development program. that looks both at how to enhance food security at the national level and at the continental level as well. And this is strongly supported by many initiatives at the international level, but in particular by the European Union. And that's why I was saying that it has to start from an agenda that is owned by the Africans of how to tackle the issues and then be accompanied by Europe. The other aspect, of course, is just the question of emergency and the emergency aid that Europe is providing, and that's something different.
That is important in very extreme, difficult situations. Very well, Sano Sibilal, we will carry on with our conversation later on. Mas Bruxelas é o palco habitual de inúmeras cimeiras. A cidade recebe por estes dias a maior delegação de chefes de Estado e de Governo da sua história, ultrapassando 6 dezenas. Espreitemos por isso agora os líderes que estão a chegar ao Conselho Europeu, mesmo ao lado do nosso estúdio.
And Africa be enhanced, become stronger and stronger in terms of economic development.
Why is this meeting so important?
Because of the relationship between the European Union and Africa.
It's an exciting moment with a great deal of opportunity now in relations between European Union countries and the countries of the African Union.
A segurança é um dos temas mais importantes desta cimeira, que analisará desafios como a luta contra a pirataria marítima, o terrorismo e os conflitos interreligiosos. A União Europeia tem atualmente missões militares na Somália, Mali e República Centro-Africana. I go back to the conversation with my guest in the studio, Sano Sibilal. Let's talk about a little bit of the cooperation in terms of military action. The EU is more than a month behind the schedule to send a mission of less than 1,000 troops to the Central African Republic that has been ravaged by interreligious killings. What's the explanation? Is lack of willingness for European Union to keep on transferring help in terms of military cooperation?
Well, I think that's a broader difficulty for Europe to ask to act fast and in a unanimous way when it comes to military action. So it is not related in particular to Africa. I think that, of course, the fact that a country like France intervened very quickly in Mali and intervened in Central African Republic, has been welcomed by the international community and has been done together with in consultation with the European Union and the other member states. But it's true that the response has been extremely slow, and I think there's a reluctance by many in Europe to get engaged, to send soldiers to the field and to get engaged directly, to provide some financing that's easier. And that's something that they are more willing to do. To send troops is something that is much more difficult, and especially if it's under a European mandate.
But that means that, you know, being willing to send money, like you said, the money is sent for a purpose, is to help Africa to be able to prevent and respond to these challenges. And EU has transferred 1.2 billion euros over a decade for the Africa Peace Facility Program, it's called. What is your evaluation in terms of this effort? Is it still making a productive transformation?
Yes, it has been very effective, and that's an area where the cooperation has been good. Of course, one could always expect that there is more, but I mean the purpose has been both to address some of the crises, but also to strengthen the capacity of the Africans to address their own problems. And so in that sense, I think the cooperation has been very fruitful. Of course, the attention, the public attention, is always captured by the areas of crisis, but there are also many preventing efforts that are made to try to facilitate the process, to also the capacity of the European Union to combine this role in support in peacekeeping, as well as the reconstruction afterwards, both in direct humanitarian aid, what we're talking about before, but also the whole effort of helping a country to reconstruct is very important, and the European Union has been quite effective in accompanying these kind of processes. But we would, of course, hope that the results are coming faster.
It would be better. Thank you very much for your insight for the moment. We will speak later on more economical issues. Até agora, as relações União Europeia-África têm sido marcadas pela transferência de ajuda para a África, mas agora os dois blocos querem passar para um modelo de parceria mais equilibrado, ancorado em comércio e investimento. Falaremos disso com maior detalhe na segunda parte do nosso programa especial, dentro de meia hora. Por agora, passamos à emissão regular. Até já!